Casuals version. Brad was my second character, and I used to use Wolf. Bangkok can use a wide variety of characters, but in a tournament, he go for the matchup.
Yeah.
If Shun gets it done, then Shun gets it done. If Jackie get it done, then Jackie get it done. But neither are the people that I'm calling out.
Okay, wait, hold on one second. It doesn't really matter that much if someone switches their main, but I'm gonna agree with LA Akira. Shun is not as good in this.
Not as good at all.
He was
not
really good in Virgin C.
Shout out to LA Akira.
So it's natural that some people switch when they feel that it's a little harder to win with a certain character. It's just natural to do that.
Right.
Nobody switches their character when they realize, hey, I can win really easy with this character, so let me switch. No, people don't do that.
Nah, that fuck that. How I don't abandon my main.
Yeah, you know, the thing about Shun, he sucks at the wall. First of all, he doesn't have chow on. He doesn't have at least 8 drinks.
Right, right.
Without the wall. All right, hold on.
Oh, shit, there it is. Tricky's calling Denkai out. Get your pose ready.
Oh, snap. It gets no better than this.
You got Theo Huxtable versus Arnold Drummond. Because you know Denkai was the original dude with the Gary Coleman syndrome from back in the day.
That's right, yeah.
You always had the Gary Coleman syndrome. But yo, shout outs to Tricky and Denkai. Shout outs to Shag. Me and Shag on the mic. Tech Monkey in the back, making it do what it do to provide this stream. Yo, you know what, man? Matter of fact, all you motherfuckers give up $10, man. Donate $10 to Tech Monkey right fucking now, man.
Because yeah,
look. And I knock on your door with the hammer drawn. Give it up. Nah. With the hammer drawn.
Yeah.
But nah. Oh, man.
So we're going to have the emoticons and little splash points just like the old.
Yeah,
old
definitely.
FGC streams. So.
She'll know soon enough. But yo, all in all, yo, This is how we do though. This is how we do. Yo, shout outs to B Fec. Shout outs to B Fec. You know why?
Because you gotta drop the B. Yeah, it's just Fec.
Yeah, it's
just Fec now.
You know why? Because I had a little. I was going back and forth with Fec today, mm-hmm. And then Fec was like, "But all you do is play online. I said, "Yo, listen, I'm a monster offline."
No, you know what? I came in late on the conversation. I saw in the shout box, and yeah. I was like, "Yo, man." I ain't gonna lie, man. You pushed my shit in last night, yo.
Shag is coming back. Shag ain't gonna go out like that. Shag had to go to a party. So I sent him on his way, because if he ain't get VF in, he would have waited and went to the party late just to get his games in. So I had to push him out the door. Arnold Drummond. What you talking about, Willis? Nah,
all right, I think we're gonna start up now, folks. Let's just bring him back up.
Yeah.
But Tricky's real. He's real hungry from his loss. And,
right. And you know what? I'm not mad at that.
He's hungry now. He did pretty good.
I love it.
So he's really feeling himself now. He wants to, you know.
Yeah.
Tricky's reaching that next level.
Yeah.
No pun intended. You know.
He's
really stepped up his game, man. For SS.
Dedicated. Very, very dedicated. Very dedicated. That's all I want. The talk is cheap. Right, Shag?
What's going on?
What's good? Oh.
I want some pie.
Just to get his crack pie.
Put up the cam.
Denkai plays on pad.
Yo, he's got that. Yo, we feeding the homeless man up in here. He's homeless. And he stands there Sing it for my name.
Nah, ribs is touching, nah, but make me wait. Nah, mess around and I'm going to bite you and smash that plate. Stop being gritty. Stop being gritty.
Nah, I guess it's my turn to get a little piece of that pie.
Oh, man.
Okay, get one. All right, what's going on?
They started. When you finish tech, yeah, all right. Back to the action.
Uh-oh. That guy's getting that one little piece. Oh. Yeah, he loves to try to finish with them lightning kicks, man. Oh, damn.
Denkai
finally gets that in.
Finally. Long, it took long enough. Denkai takes the first round. I'm not even going to attempt to do no damn commentary because I'm not good at it.
What are you doing now?
No, I'm talking about the color commentary.
Right.
But
right.
I will tell you this. When I see certain moves I know being landed, like, look, a low sweep. Look. Denkai takes
that
round
guy's
two.
Like, yeah, he got this. Yeah, he's like, I got this.
Denkai playing with a whole lot of confidence right now.
He's look, like, I got my food. Look, I got my drink
look,
on.
Look.
He got his crack pie.
He got that pie in his system.
Uh-oh.
Doing a little yeah, Tricky ain't like that shit.
Oh, that whiff.
Yeah, surprisingly.
High angle.
Oh, shit.
Big damage.
Big prizes.
I love it.
World up. Tricky. Denkai runs away with it.
Tricky's looking a little focused now. He's like,
oh, shit. Yeah, he getting mad now.
Denkai was tight.
Uh-huh.
Bringing up that sweater power.
Oh, wow.
Oh, man. He was just playing. Wow. He was just playing around, yo.
Yeah, he was just playing around.
He's like, yo, man, you are my food, man. I'm
Tricky,
gonna eat you.
I think Tricky mouthful to check his body can't cash at the moment. Yeah. This one's looking ugly unless he do something real fast.
He's gonna come back though.
Yeah, he'll come back. He probably just gotta get the speed underneath his legs because he was playing against other people that don't move that fast. So okay, look.
Tricky needs some crack pie.
Yeah, he needs the crack pie.
I'm going to get Jacko from here.
All right, no doubt. Into Jacko.
Crack pie.
Jackpot in the building.
What's good, people? What's good?
Give it up. Pay homage.
Woo, got my Heineken.
Got the Heineken.
About to give me some crack pie.
Yeah, yo, can I get a slice of pie, fellas?
Yeah, save some.
Yeah, man, let me get that. Two's good looking out, my man. Two, bam, there you go.
Give me the crack. Looking like little Debbie coffee cakes.
Like a little Debbie, where your mama?
Of course I did, yo.
Yo. Knockout. You know what this shit tastes like?
This shit really tastes like crack.
This shit tastes like something that tastes good.
Daily pie from pie.
Oh my God, this shit is good. This shit is crack right here. This shit is crack.
Yeah, I feel like I'm gonna start fucking people up now.
I think I'm gonna fucking steal me another piece. They might have to hide this shit. They might have to hide this shit.
Hide the bot. Hide your kids. Hide your wife.
Yeah. Hide your kids. Hide the pot.
Yeah, hide that pot.
Shit, real in the film.
So yeah, what is? Oh my God. Look at him. Look at the sneaky run back.
I believe that was two.
Look at Joe Theo is cheesing right now.
Salty run back. Chick is hungry.
Uh-huh.
You know how the saying of Soul Calibur goes? The soul still burns. Nah, niggas, the salt still burns.
Fucking sodium levels rising.
We call that the Insta Ramen run back.
Uh-huh.
Insta Ramen got mad sodium. So mad sodium. So it's tricky right now. Got the sodium on deck.
Mad sodium. We gonna call Tricky right now until he win a match. Lowry's seasoning salt.
Yo, real quick, this fucking pie is good.
It's
fucking good. I don't think it was exaggerating.
This shit that you like, you find yourself eating Lowry.
Yo, that face.
Yeah, there's that face.
Oh, man.
Morton's a diamond salt.
But look, I'm gonna put it to you like this. This fucking pie is so good. Yo, this is the kind of pie that you eat after a marathon. Yeah. Like, yo, after you get some ass or something and you want to raid the fridge, if this is sitting there, fuck the chicken, fuck the steak. This is what you want to eat. You know what this feel like? This feel like when you get an evade dash cancel into a throw escape. And then you get the side turn mid kick and you win the match. That's what this shit tastes like.
That's the best way to describe it.
Rolled into one. Oh yeah. Man, get you some, Tech.
Oh, he's happy. Look at him cheating. Look at him trying to hold the smile. He's trying to hold his smile. Look at him trying to hold the smile.
Gotta get Tech his face, man.
Yeah, he wants some crack pie.
Damn.
No, he
actually
tricked
you
just one.
Yeah. Tricky,
I just caught that. I was laughing at his face the whole time. I'm the Johnny come lately to the joke.
Huh? Morton's.
Oh.
No, Morton's.
I was laughing at because he had the serious face, but I knew it was on the name of Morton's.
Oh, he kicked the bitch down.
Oh, man.
Yeah, fuck that shit.
Oh. Oh.
That kick is so good.
I mean, it's not.
The properties on it.
Yeah.
Isn't it like half circular?
Yeah, the first kick brings you up into the second kick.
Oh, come on.
Just kick you away. So most of these
Yeah.
Because the first one can kick you up. And this one, the first kick hits you in the shoulder. And the second one finishes you off.
Oh, okay.
In the layman's terms.
That Jackie knowledge.
The double dragon. Oh shit.
Yeah, that's a good kick though because it's good for like combo. It keeps it
right.
Combo.
Perfect combo ender.
Yeah.
I wouldn't dare do that shit mid round though for no reason.
Nah. But isn't it like plus four on block?
Yeah. No, if you can see Tech Monkey face, you think he hit the lottery.
And I know I said fuck Frame Data earlier, but at the same time, that shit need to be icing on the cake.
Yeah.
Not something y'all shouldn't rely solely on that, you know? Get your visuals down,
right.
Then the Frame Data is icing on the cake.
Because when you have the visual and you know what's coming, you react better.
Oh, hell yeah. Hell yeah.
So, it ain't like, oh, okay.
You gotta try to think numbers now.
Right,
now.
Don't
yeah,
play the numbers
yeah,
game.
Yeah, nah.
Don't try to play the numbers game. Just know.
Yeah, it's not bad, not at all.
That's all it is, right?
I see one.
Just know. Just know if somebody do 2P, just know that you can move first.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
In layman's terms.
Yeah, exactly.
But against certain characters, it might not be the wisest option.
Yeah.
To move first.
Keep the distance.
Oh. The crust. The best part. The best part.
Yo, I'm savoring my crack pot.
Yo, don't
SBS right. Done devoured his shit.
I tore it up. Yo, me and Jack over here pigging out. Tech Monkey took a break. A well-deserved break because he was manning the boards.
Oh, yeah.
So that's cool. I see you, Tricky.
You mean Morton, but he's not Morton now.
I see you. Oh, he's Tricky now.
Yeah, change his name to Gas. He's Mad Gas right now.
Yeah.
You gotta call him Gas.
Mad Gas.
Or Hype, or whatever. Or Cheesing. He's Cheesing right now. So, I overheard SGS talking about playing VF4. Evo, and then going into five.
No,
having the what you call it? Without knowledge.
Right.
Yeah.
I actually missed Evo.
You know what we call that though? We call that quest mode syndrome.
Right.
When you play quest mode so much,
and you start to adapt to the bad habits of spamming against the AI.
Right.
You try that shit online or against that a real opponent. Oh, you get fucked up so bad.
And
been there, done that.
Right. And see, the thing was, we used to play VF4 and Evo at Bad Seed's house. My homeboy, shout out to the Bad Seed. That's my brother from another mother. We used to sit in his crib, and it used to be me, him, Akmar, Yes Master, my other homeboy, Roachy Violet, and a few of us. We played all games. Don't get it twisted.
Oh, yeah.
Virtual Fighter was just one of them. I wasn't into Virtual Fighter as much as I am now, but I played it. I mean, we get together, we played Mark of the Wolves, Real Bout.
Aw, SNK.
Martial Masters on Super Gun. Yeah, we did it all.
Breakers.
We did it all. But VF was when the most shit talking came.
Oh, yeah.
And,
You gotta hit him with one of these chairs.
The problem with VF was, I didn't really know how to tech throws, so I used to fall for Vanessa's gut punch into low throw.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Because I didn't know which direction, and I didn't know you could input multiple. And that shit used to tear off half. I used to get so frustrated because I'm like, here I am going through a flow chart, and then that mid punch come, bow. And then next thing you know, low throw. And I used to actually do DMPK a lot too. I did it all. I mean, the shit was a part of the game to us.
Yeah, it was.
Then, you know, as Vanilla came out, DMPK was like soft, man. Everybody didn't like it. But I was like, man, fuck that shit. If it work, I'm going to do it.
Word.
But as I got better and I learned the intelligent way, I became VF savvy. I abandoned that shit.
Oh, when
I
you said,
fuck it, I'm not going to take this when I can get a side turn, launch, or something like that.
When you become VF savvy, the game becomes a whole lot more fun.
Yeah. A whole lot more.
I don't know. It's just with this version. I mean, you probably heard this so many times. It's even, even more online.
Right.
It's not as rewarding. FP, Evo is very rewarding. When you get shit out, you know that punishable. You earned it. Not so much someone made a mistake just on their part. It's on both sides. You fucking earned it.
Right. You earned it.
That's Murph knowledge.
Bottom motherfucking line. There it is. You gotta earn it.
You gotta earn it, man.
And it's like you don't see. I was always told that if it comes easy, it goes easy. So when you shortcut the learning VF, and then you end up getting your ass whipped because you never learned. Now you gotta start from the ground up. You gotta basically go back to the lab and tune your shit up. Once you learn from the ground up and you broke all the bad habits and you slowly put it together. You gotta take the losses as a learning experience. So what you wanna do is you wanna find that one person that's your boogeyman basically that you can't beat. You wanna say, okay, out of this set, I wanna at least win 2 games. Now I won 3. I wanna win 5 games next time. Okay, I won 4. Cool. Now, at least I know that out of the matches, I managed to go to 5 rounds 80% of the time. That's growth. Now you just take it and just say, you know what, maybe I need to evade throw cancel more. Maybe he's punishing me for failed evades. Now you got to go back and look at the replays and say, you know what, I'm going to work on my weaknesses. Or if I'm not going to work on my weaknesses, I'm going to try to hide the holes. Sort of like the Patriots defense.
Oh, boy.
The Patriots defense appears strong because Bill Belichick knows how to hide the weaknesses, basically. Even though Asante Samuel wasn't the best at that position, he was disciplined. He didn't break plays. So being that you're disciplined, it goes very far. It goes very far. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to have all the max damage combos. You don't have to have a wall combo. But if you're disciplined and you know when to strike and you know when to punish correctly, you can get far. All that combo shit will come later on in the game. Fuck that. It's going to come. It'll be there. You're going to always get your chance. You know, it's easy to score, but it's just hard to get the shot off. That's it.
And unfortunately, my team's quarterback is drop the combo, Romo. Romo, I'm a Cowboys fan. Romo, great quarterback, man, but that dude is not clutch. Oh man, that man panicked, yo. It's like when you get your launcher in VF, you drop the easiest combo at Romo. Romo gets the perfect throw and drops the ball. Interception. And sad face, you know, couldn't make the playoffs. That's another story.
And there was and they said, do you know how to say Tony Romo in Spanish? Mark Sanchez. Yeah, no, let me stop. Yo, look, I'm a Giants fan.
Better
man.
Sanchez and Tebow,
right? I'm a Giants fan, man. We win the final damn game of the season and still go home, man, and we Super Bowl champs.
That hurt. Win, body, body,
body.
And it's like I said, if there's ever a 5-on-5, Philly versus New York, if you watch that Giants game, there you go. You already know how it's gonna turn out.
You know how it's gonna turn out.
Philly is not beating New York.
No, it should be at Evo, but more than likely it'll probably be a side tournament. Hey, the great
Winter Ball maybe or something.
Yeah,
I mean, I'm going to Winter Ball, so that'd be pretty cool to see that. Hey, I doubt I'll be a candidate for New York, but I'm confident that
what's that?
New York will take it.
Of course. Look, you still got people crying about Jackie. You know what it is? Jackie moves a little too fast and people get intimidated by the speed of him.
Yeah.
But I'm going to be honest with you. Contrary to popular beliefs, some of you people who still think 2P is sin, 2P is the only way you're going to beat Jackie. Get used to it. I don't care who you are.
Just don't be a 2P spammer too much.
Right, no. But to interrupt him,
you have to interrupt him. You can't wait
for him to finish because he can stop his stream so easily and flow into something else.
But, you know, like I said, bad habits, and then you get a 7K 50%.
Yeah.
So you know, I seen that. It said VF2, VF2 7.
Right.
Oh, man. But, yeah, Jackie is not as scary. Honestly, in all sincerity, you want to talk about scary offense? I think Brad is probably.
Oh, yeah.
Potential.
Oh, yeah.
Brad is hands down.
Oh, yeah.
The fucking scariest offensive character in the game.
Oh, yeah.
Because.
Oh, yeah.
I think his mix up is actually stronger than Jackie's.
Exactly.
And when you really like break it down to the wire, yeah, Brad is definitely scarier.
Right. And not only that.
I don't know what the fuck this was. 5-3.
Not only that, Brad. If I'm not mistaken, his 6 PK is a great punisher at 14 frames. So if you guard a launcher, that elbow leads to about 79 on 9 on non-counter. Easily.
And y'all complain about Jackie?
Right. Right. And this is what I'm telling people. Brad has the tools. He might not have the mix-ups that Jackie do, but his punishing game is far more superior than Jackie.
And when you got a punishing game in VF, it's like, hey, let your opponent attack and punish. Get the best punish
possible. See, Jackie will punish a launcher with 3 PPP, 6 PK, PK.
Yeah.
And he's not getting much damage. But Brad, 6 PK, that shit leads to 79 to 80 damage. That spinning fucking elbow alone.
Yes.
But they don't hear me, though. They don't hear me, though.
Nah. Jackie's the VF boogie, man. It's okay, though. I run with Jeffrey and Sour all day.
Brad punishing is so good that his throws take a backseat. He don't need to use
hey,
the
yo,
throw.
Oh, my God.
He don't need to throw.
He really doesn't, yo.
That's why his throws is weak.
You can't even say the icing on the cake. They're really just there for show.
Right.
When he says the big-time player is here, he's really here. Yeah, Brad is no joke. See, I don't play Brad. I don't play Jackie. But I respect the fuck out of people who play them and play them well, because you know anyone can say, "Oh, Jackie's an easy character to pick up," and to an extent he is, but he's not an easy character to master.
Right, he's easy to play, but see this is watch this. I'm about to turn the world on his head. This is the story of VF Final Showdown in a nutshell. agree to disagree, agree, whatever. Jackie is supposed to be the easiest character to pick up and play, yet he's the hardest to master, right? But Akira is the hardest character to use, but he's the flagship character of the series, right? Now, if you look at fucking Sega All-Star Racing, there's a reason why Jackie and Akira are in the same fucking car, and the car is red. Because when you put them two motherfuckers together,
that's all you see is red.
You get Gene. Okay? When you put them two together, you get Gene. You can fucking deny it all you want.
I'm coming up.
All right. I'm going up. Jacko going up. I got after Jacko. But this is what I'm trying to tell you. So you can agree to disagree. You can do whatever the fuck you want to do. I don't care. I'm here. You're there. But, like I said.
All right. Yes. Tricky, how does it feel now that you got your lickings in?
All I wanted was to show was no ass whooping. Be like, yo, you can beat me. I know you can beat me. But, like.
But I'm going to bring it to you anyway.
Exactly.
He didn't go out like a bitch is what he's trying to say.
That's what's important.
Yeah.
That's important. If you're going to go down, make it hard.
Yeah, don't. Yo, listen. I was always told you never die with a full clip. It's embarrassing.
That better be empty.
Yeah, it better be empty.
All of that stuff.
And if your gun ain't warm, then that mean you're the traitor. You're the one that gave us up.
Mm-hmm. You didn't fire hard enough.
Yeah, you didn't fire
you didn't
it
fire enough.
So if your gun is cold, then that means you wasn't doing shit.
Right. Now, I wanted to do more fights. Of course I want to do more fights.
Right.
But, you know, I was like, okay. Like 6'3". Yeah. Deal with that.
We can deal with that. We can live with that. Because most people can't even get
three.
One.
One.
10 yeah. on Denkai.
Right. Right.
Some people can't even get 2-10 on me. Shiny.
Oh, he just said it. He just said it. No.
But I'm just saying,
it's on
though.
Video, though.
Yeah. But I'm just
yeah.
saying, though.
Right.
If you want to do something about it, then don't lose.
Yeah.
But guess what? By Tricky losing, he just leveled up.
Exactly. I learned new shit today, just now,
yeah.
from that fight.
So he just leveled up.
From that fight.
And the new tech that he's working on is actually working.
Right.
But as soon as he master how to implement it.
Exactly.
It'll be level up.
Yup.
Then I'll have to change my shit a bit.
Right.
There it is.
Because everybody knows about the tech now, everyone knows that's out there.
Oh,
they're announcing games for Evo.
Right.
So our viewer kind of just like took a nosedive, I'm imagining.
How many?
I mean, that's cool. That's not bad at all. Cool. That's pretty good for us.
Deal with it.
So, what I want to do is get that tech under my belt so I can just whip it out whenever I want.
Yeah, look, it takes time.
It's gonna take time. And like, what's rough about it is that I can't practice it on like not strong players because they don't do
they
it.
Won't, right, they won't know what they're being hit put
with.
To the test. Right.
Exactly.
So unless you're playing against the upper tier, the stronger players,
I can't practice it.
You won't.
I can't practice it.
It's not your fault.
Yeah.
So that means that I'm going to have to get online, and me and Tricky's going to have to run an hour session.
Right. That's how we do.
And that's how we do.
That's exactly how we do it.
We don't do first to five and then leave before somebody get downloaded.
No.
I want to get downloaded.
Right.
This is file share.
P2P, my man.
Word up. Peer to peer. Player to player. Person to person. Partner to partner.
So when we show up like this, and get to do our run back.
Right.
That's not because, like, you know, we're mad, of course, whatever. But
yeah.
we also, we're but, like, yo, I want to know if I can make that adjustment.
Yeah.
Can I make that adjustment?
Right.
And, like, what makes you and Denkai and, like, Rodney and Adam and GT strong, I mean, the other guys too, is getting main.
Right.
Is that mid-round, you'll make that adjustment.
Yeah, you have to.
More than what?
Right.
So, like, maybe four times in a round that'll adjust what we made, and that's going to win you that round. And you have to do that every single round
right,
in the match.
Right.
And that's what I'm working on, like, right
but
now.
You can't. Yeah, listen. See, with me, that ability came, and I'm not tooting my own horn. That came from the days that I would come outside, right?
Mm-hmm.
My older brothers and them, they'll be in the game room playing Street Fighter. So So I'll be the last person to come outside because I'm finally in the house and I can play my game without them interrupting me.
Right.
So, like, I'll make it to the game room. As soon as I walk in the game room, whether it's from the cold or whether I was doing something, they're playing Street Fighter.
Yep.
They're losing. So it's Mo. Yo, Mo, take this game and win by all means necessary. If I lose their money, I'm going to get screamed on.
Of course.
So I had to get on Street Fighter 2 or Street Fighter 1, mm-hmm. and I had to win.
Right.
Mid-round with whatever energy
oh,
I had
oh,
left.
I've had people do that shit to me back, right. back in Chinatown if they were still right. around.
So, so what that does is that when, as I got older, there was no pressure because the real pressure was I had to try to salvage these games for my brothers.
Right.
So after I win the game, I got to give it back to them.
Yeah, right.
So after I beat Blanca or somebody up, I gotta give it back to him.
Like, here, it's your turn.
You know, so it was, oh, shit, all right, you give me my game back, I'll call you when I need you.
Right, so you're constantly saving
right.
them.
So although we all in the arcade, once I got the call, yo, bro, come save the game, man, I'm about to lose. There it was. Mm. If other dudes came from other games and they came to the game, yo, bro, they got some dude in there playing Street Fighter, he beating everybody.
Beat him off. Yeah.
Here I come down the block because I'm outside playing, doing whatever it is I'm doing. Yo, Mo, we need you. So I got you. I got a dollar, so my mom gave me a dollar. Yo, we got to go clear it out.
Yep.
All right. So my friends will pick the character and be like, yo, I want you to do it with this character. Mm. Nah, do it with him. So they were sponsoring me.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, here's and your then, quarter. Do it.
Right. So then, not only that, but I also had, watch this now, the drug dealers, the hustlers that come into the game room with all the rings on, all the jewelry. They just want to play video games. They don't want to lose either.
Mm-mm.
But I had a rival. That's my homeboy, SDS Clap-A-Lot.
What?
He was my Street Fighter rival. You know, my friends, then shout outs to Clapper. I love you. That's my brother right there. That's my brother. I love him to death.
Word.
He was like the yin to my yang.
Mm.
So what used to happen was the hustlers used to bet money on who could beat who.
Sure.
So the whole thing was, look, it don't matter who wins. Because we gonna split the pot when we leave out.
Exactly. Right.
So, dude would be like, yo, I bet you $5 he ain't gonna beat Tricky with Dow. And he'd be like, yo, I'm matching. So,
right.
we get a percentage, win or lose.
Sure.
So there was no pressure.
Nah, it's like
the hustlers
win.
Had it.
Yeah.
So when they win, they'd be like, yeah, shorty, you made me some money. Yeah, hold that.
Yeah.
So they put money in our pocket. But when we leave, yo, we split it.
Of course.
Go to the store.
Yeah.
Do what we do.
Hell yeah, man.
That was Friday nights for us.
Mm. That's a good night.
About, right, I'm talking about as an 11-year-old.
That's some lot of money, an 11-year-old, right. man.
The Street Fighter 2 came out in 91. I was in the fifth grade.
Man.
Yeah, I'm 31 now.
yeah.
So
I was.
Street Fighter is 25.
I think I was 4 or 5. I was just getting ready to walk. some shit like that.
Right. So all of that came from all of that pressure situation being in a game room, cigarette smoke.
Oh, I made this
like
easy.
Eight people standing around, quarters on top of the star.
Yeah.
Yo, I got next. Yo, knowing dudes had guns on them. Just
right.
The violence of it.
Right.
I wasn't supposed to be in there, but I was in there, Chicky.
Yeah, man.
So now when you tell me to sit down and play here, this is nothing. You telling me that I'm going to feel tournament jitters? How? When I had to play for money amongst hustlers that shoot guns and sell drugs.
When they get mad, might, you know.
When they get, right, and they arguing, and we ain't supposed to be in the game.
Yeah, but you're kicking ass. They're like, yo, well,
I'm kicking ass and making
gonna show up.
My older brother coming. What you doing in here? Yo, get out the game room and smack me.
Hell yeah.
Dig in my pockets.
Pop.
You see, I got a couple of coins. Yo, man, give me this.
You're right.
And he start playing the game. I couldn't go say, mommy, such and such.
No, you weren't supposed to be there.
Because I wasn't supposed to be
there. Yeah, you being busted is my trouble.
Right, so I was getting shook. I was getting shaken down but by my own brother. But guess what? I love every minute of it because that shit made me a monster.
You have that mental toughness.
Right.
That mental toughness.
Right. And that's where it comes from. So even as I get older, I know my reflex slow. But my ability to still see three movements ahead.
Oh, yeah.
It makes up for my dexterity.
Right,
Sometimes I might do a fairly vague. Why? Because my mental is not like when I was a young kid.
Of course.
You know what I'm saying? Sometimes it become too taxing to do an evade.
Dash cancel every single time.
Right, because against certain people, they're not going to punish that shit.
So it's like, fuck it, I don't even
right.
do it. And,
right.
And that's something that can happen to anybody, you know?
Anybody.
Anybody has that problem. It takes discipline
to do that kind of attack against a player that you don't need to do it on.
Right.
But that's a good, like I've been trying to, because, you know, good players should fight weaker players to help weaker players become strong. Because folks did that to me when I was trying to get better. And I'm still trying to get better. And folks still do that for me. So every once in a while, you know, I'll fight somebody who I know I can beat pretty bad. And what I'll do is I'll practice my newest tech on them. Like the most.
You did good though, Jacko.
Yeah, it was good shit. The most raw stuff that like I'm just getting a grasp on. Because basically to me, they're like a training dummy in dojo mode. No offense to those players.
I
want to make it interesting for me too.
Yeah, of course.
So
you don't want to land every move you throw out?
No.
You don't want to land every move you throw out. There ain't nothing fun about that.
Yeah. Practice my combos. I can do that in dojo.
Exactly. And there's nothing fun about beating on big mouths
who
can't fucking play.
No.
There's nothing fun about that.
Nah.
Because, I mean, in an arcade, I would let the person win one just to make it a fight.
Right.
And then win it and then be like, yo, you tried. Good shit.
Yeah.
And I was never a bad sport.
Yeah, you know, you gotta be good about it. You be like, hey,
you gotta be good about it.
And you know, I know
it's a blessing to play video games at any point of the day.
Yeah,
you know, at any time.
Hop online, bam. Like,
right, there's people who can't play video games that want to play video games.
Right.
Whether it's a disability.
Mm-hmm.
Whether they don't know how to play or they just want to get into it but they can't.
You don't have the time to dedicate. You know, like shit. This thing right here.
Right.
I made this.
I'm a believer.
Because my wrists were hurting too hard.
Right.
And like I basically can play on joystick still, whatever, but if I do that for too long, it just hurts.
Right, now watch this. I co-signed that because I was diagnosed with parathesis.
Mm.
And parathesis is like an upgrade to carpal tunnel.
Right. I had tendonitis.
Right.
I was gonna get this carpal tunnel, but I didn't deal with it.
Right, and a lot of people don't know. I get the tingling sensation in my left hand when it sits dormant. So sometimes when I'm controlling the joystick, I can't feel my strength controlling the joystick. So while I get frustrated thinking, yo, why am I not stepping
because my hand ain't working?
No, it's because from playing games and doing what I've been doing for so long, the muscle gradually loses strength because of the paradisus.
Yeah.
So occasionally I have to go lift a weight.
Yep.
I might throw some air punches just to keep my arm tight.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh man, that's a workout. Last year, he's cracking. He's like, yeah, man.
No homo.
Yeah, but
Jacko got the mad hard stick. Just so you guys know.
Right. So when Chicky told me that he was having problems with his wrist, I already knew what it was.
You knew exactly.
Because I was diagnosed with the shit.
Yep.
Like I said, this shit is no joke.
Right.
Because I get pins and needles.
Yes.
Like you know when your legs fall asleep, I might get that shit in my hand.
That's
just
no
off
fun.
The rip.
Right. Right.
Right.
See,
you know what I'm saying? So,
years ago, when I first had this problem, when it first hit me, I went to the doctor and was like, yo, I have this problem. How can we fix it? They said, oh, well, your tendons are inflamed. Let's let's open your wrist up and just cut your tendons to make your...
Right, alleviate the pressure.
And I'm like, well, yeah, is that going to mess with my dex? Because I'm a musician, too. So
right.
I'm like, yo, is that going to mess with my saxophone playing? And they said... Yeah, it might. And I'm like, yo, fuck that shit. What can I do without you cutting me? So, oh, well, just, you know, relax and don't use it as much as you are. And like, I was a music minor, so I had to practice. I was typing a lot because I had classes and papers to do, and I was playing video games.
They wanted to cut you open just to get the money.
Oh, hell yeah. They were like, yo, you don't want to get yourself cut? I'm like, no.
Right.
So, like, I'm all about if you can do something behaviorally to fix it,
right?
Do that shit, son.
Well, that surgery shit, no, we don't do that surgery shit. Our hands mean everything. You heard what Ryu said. My hands mean everything to me. Yo, I broke my left thumb in 92. I still was playing Street Fighter with a motherfucking cast on.
Damn.
I broke my left wrist in 91. I still was in Playland 2 with an orange and yellow cast on.
This man's hard.
Yo, look.
Core.
Hardcore.
Hardcore.
Hard as they motherfucking come.
I want to smoke my pinky right here.
Wow.
Right here.
Wow. Look, I put it to you like this. If you look at my fingers from playing basketball and stuff and playing sports, I jammed it and it has, see it? Look, you see it?
Yep.
And that's on my button pressing finger.
Oh, man.
Look, my index finger, this happened last summer. I has a permanent swell because I was playing basketball and a dude reached for the ball and hit my finger.
Damn.
So that's my trigger finger in Gears of War. That's my focus finger. I had to use this hand. I had to use this finger, excuse me. And it felt uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm.
Holding a joystick in my hand hurt it because my left index finger is my down and forward motions.
Oh.
My thumb is my up and back motions.
This right here, this is just super,
wow, look,
super tight.
Look, hold
double
on. Let me see.
Let me see
if I can show you this. This is Jacko's stick. You see this?
This thing right here, really right. Tight. He has like three springs
now,
in that shit.
Now, let me show you. What I was trying to explain to you guys about my fingers and the Ori stick was that my left index finger is used for down motion. See? Damn, wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Right?
God damn, what that is? This is a medicine? Yo, wow.
That's a workout, man.
Now, as a kid when I was younger, I used to hold a controller like this.
Mm-hmm.
As my hands got bigger, it became like this because Capcom didn't make the ball joysticks no more.
That's how I did.
Once Ori, right. So
I love me some back out.
Right. So once Ori came out, I had to learn how to use this because I couldn't do this no more because it was resting on my knee. So when my index finger was down, forward, my thumb became up and back. So if you ever look, you'll see it. Look.
All two fingers.
Right. When I jammed this motherfucking finger playing basketball, I couldn't play Virtua Fighter.
Mm.
I was frustrated sitting in a house bored. I wasn't playing Gears and Call of Duty like I was because just kind of played out to me, basically. But I remember soaking my finger in vinegar and Epsom salt. Get the swelling down.
The truth.
And once the swelling down went down ever so slightly, I started playing VF again.
Right.
Sore fucking finger and all. I couldn't step the way I wanted to.
Nope.
But I could still play.
Right.
I could still play. Right.
Yeah, it was John.
How
you do it? Yeah. Like,
right.
I mean, Rod, I used
as far as this joystick goes, you gotta feel it. From it has no slack in it, basically.
None.
And I can tell this shit is durable just by the way it feels. I can tell it's durable, of course.
Did you put a third stick in there?
Right.
There's only two springs. Right. Okay, two LX.
LS32
springs.
Right.
Yo, Styles heading out.
I'm glad you came out, though, man. I was supposed to leave early also. But you know what?
Fuck it, man.
I probably even like the next 30 minutes, though.
Oh, word?
Yeah,
yo, we should get on the fucking.
Right, yeah, hell yeah. But if you can feel this joystick, this shit has no slack to it. It's stiff. But me being the gamer that I am, I can adapt, right? I can get my shit off. If I'm in the crib and it's the only thing I got,
you make it work.
I'm gonna make it do what it do. Bottom line, I'm make it do what it do. No motherfucking excuses. Shit, I use a keyboard if I have to. I can use Tricky's hitbox if. Show him.
You know you play on keyboard when you play Mugen.
Mugen. That, you see it? Look, that's up. If I can move this here, I can use that just as well as I use a stick. Right.
Where are my Mugen players at? Keyboard.
Huh?
Mugen.
Yeah, Mugen. Keyboard. Mugen. Mugen.
Before fucking Win Mugen came out with the fucking controller support, keyboard all the way.
All right. So when I was playing that Dose Mugen, and mind you, I'm a creator too, but.
We about to do a picture over here.
Yeah, hold on. We about to take
VFC
a picture
or something
to show y'all how we do tech. Let's go,
We got darknesses in the house. Shaq knew that was coming. Because we all mad dark and shit. So when we take photos in this dark room, it's hard to see our faces sometimes.
I'm advertising right now. This is a shameless plug.
Do it.
Closing off with Jack O's shit right
now. Oh, wait, okay. Let him see that. Let him see that. Watch that. Watch the fingers. See that shit? It's like a musical instrument. So, you know, Silly Pie is our guest today. So, I guess we'll let her. We're gonna let her go on there for a wee bit. Cause how often did you get to play Denkai? Really? Oh, there we go. All right. Oh. All right. What's that?
It seems like the stuff is like, oh, they started getting a little bit serious here.
Oh, yeah, yeah, they were like practicing shit, weren't they? Yo, KO, I saw you said something. What you got to say to me, boy? What you got? Yeah, you better laugh. I was about to say, he thought I didn't see you. You called as if it was giving story time. And telling everybody about how we do in New York City and where we come from. Ready, go! Yes. Wonder if Sega will sponsor FS and Evo? Well, I mean, we got the Sega Cup. So, hold up. Can anybody who's able to, like, check what the Evo games are? Yo, KO, show up to Sega Cup. We will handle this right there. I have plenty of Jeffrey practice. You see what I do to Jeffrey. So bring it, son.
Quickie, getting heated now.
Yeah. He's been trying to fight me for a while, man.
Really?
He's been trying to be first to 10 online for like, ever since I fought Tony online. And I was like, no, I'm not doing any of my first to 10s online. I just don't want to do that. But I'll do it offline. Anybody, anywhere, I'm gonna fuck when. Take care, bro.
Offline it is then.
It is. Y'all heard that here. Offline, Sega Cup. KO and I are gonna do first to 10. First to 10, me and KO. Kayamaya Sukin. Oken. First offline at Sega Cup. He's calling me out. So, I'm down with that. I'll whip you at Sega Cup.
Yes, Silly Pie's in New York City right now. She's visiting us.
On EBA? The GBN? I don't know what your tag is. All
right. Yo, you know what? I have no problem with KO doing a first time. Let me tell you something about KO. KO is misunderstood. KO might talk a lot of shit, but he step up, and not only that, but after he's humbled, he'll let you know. Yo, good shit.
Yeah.
Don't pay me no mind. I'm just talking my shit.
Right.
I'm just living right up to my troll, you know, and I'm cool with that. I'm cool with that. But there's some motherfuckers who just really take that shit to heart, and it's a damn shame because I'm like, yep, yo, look, it ain't that serious, man.
No.
Now with KO, I know KO's a troll, and he try to troll me to get a rise out of me.
That's kind of fun sometimes, you know.
You're not getting
a
rise out of me. I'm actually laughing because in order for the troll to actually hurt, you have to be able to beat me.
Yikes.
If you can't beat me, then you can't piss me off. And if you whip my ass, then I'll be like, yo, this motherfucker, now he picking on me. But it ain't that.
Uh-oh.
But.
Oh, Hubs? Oh, I'm not trying to dip you, son.
Who said what?
Apparently, I've been dipping on Hubs. I've been evading him on Xbox Live.
Yo, Hubs, I'll play you.
Just send me a message, man, when I'm online.
I'll play you, Hubs. Shit. I'll be sitting and fucking play a match for 30 minutes.
Right.
I turn the music off and then sit at the computer until I hear.
Yeah.
Get up and go play. And by then, my fucking eyelids be heavy and shit.
And okay, I still. Are you all gonna fight? Okay.
Yeah. But I don't give a fuck. I play anybody, man. I don't run.
Yeah. Anybody, anytime. It's fun.
Yeah. Then Kyle over there playing with Silly Pie.
Yeah, I think he was talking some tech to her.
Yeah. Shout out to Silly Pie.
Yeah, yo.
The
holidays. I love
for,
it.
Look, for the Lady VFs. Remember, last week I gave a shout out to the Lady VF. So even though they fall in few, they still play VF.
And they represent.
I like that.
They represent.
Shout out to Zero Chan.
Y'all haven't seen her in a while. I miss Zero Chan.
I got him through the screen.
Got him.
Got him through the screen. We love you, Zero. We love
do.
You, baby.
We
love you, baby.
Bringing hype back.
Yeah, fuck that.
People love that video, I gotta say. Gotta say. DOA 5 and SoCal.
Lady VF is that come to New York.
Let's make
love with a play with us. Please bring some crack pot. Crack pot. Too good. Eating another place right now. Yeah, that's nothing.
Oh, I'm here with some VF2 music.
Pie,
man.
Yeah, we like pie. Pie.
Yeah, that was a good one. Did y'all show them the pie that she brought? That shit would look
yeah, that shit was delicious.
That
was tricky. That shit was excellent, dude.
If I hadn't eaten dinner before I came
look,
here.
Look, she brought a gift in the whole nine.
See?
Shout out to Silly Pie.
You show up, bring us food. We love you.
And I'm the first to say, hey, don't show up to the function empty-handed.
Nope.
Shit, I came empty-handed and got a drink.
We'll fix
I was
that.
Lucky. I got a drink and some pie. Yay! Yeah! Yeah, my man Jacko on the scene. Great babe, baby. Take that. Forgot
to train, eh? I kind of want to get back in there.
Yeah.
It's getting... Yo, how are we going to do it? Yo!
Go back over there.
That,
yeah, I gotta get
down.
Back on stream.
Yeah, same here. Same
gotta
here.
Get back on stream.
But, Jacko, you need to tell him what's up? You tell him what's up? Cool.
Yeah.
Word.
This is expert right here.
So, yeah, yo, SES, do you want to go next after?
Hell yeah.
Word.
Hell yeah.
Word,
hell
word, yeah, word, word, word. Up. Man.
I don't give a fuck when I lose. Just let me play the game.
It's nice and fun. Gotta
yeah,
say.
Just let me play the game. I ain't got time to pump fake. This ain't basketball.
I do wish I could have gone all the way to first to 10 with Denkai, but that would have been long.
Yeah.
I didn't want to do that to folks. I know people want to play the game.
Yo, and you see me? Sometimes I'd rather watch a good game of VF than play it.
You know, that's true. You learn a lot from watching.
Yeah.
Especially when you like when you watch a good game, especially a player that you know.
Right.
I like to think about, well, what would I have done in that situation and would it have worked?
Right.
Then I watch, especially situations that I typically lose, I have a hard time finding ways out of it. How they got out of it. I'm like, oh,
exactly.
Shit. I should use my move that has this similar function.
Right.
Because every character, I think, more or less, has moves that serve similar functions.
Right.
And if you can think about the game that way, then you can look at a character like Jackie or look at a character like Kira and say, okay, he's mad strong. What makes him strong? Okay, he does this, this, and this to me.
Exactly.
How can I do that to somebody?
Exactly.
And that's, you know, make to do that.
Right.
I'm not going to say like...
Certain people.
Right, certain people. Certain characters just have a...
Nice.
Have to work a little more to do the same thing, but they can still do it.
They can still do it. Our motherfuckers just don't want to put that work in.
No.
Because I tell you what, part of the equation is, and me and Adam used to always talk about this. Sometimes you got to know when to slow the game down.
Mm-hmm.
You got to know when to slow it down. When it look like it's moving too fast, step
slow
back.
Down. Yep.
Step back. Slow it down a bit. Now, I don't mean fucking run. Right? I don't mean turn it up.
Mm-mm.
I don't mean none of that. I mean pay attention to what you're doing.
Right.
Right? Look at it.
And that can be hard.
Right.
In the heat of the battle, man.
But that's the experience coming.
Exactly.
If you gotta, look, and I'm guilty of this, look. If you gotta put the computer on level 7 in Dojo and just play an hour straight.
Do it.
Do it.
Master Po does that shit.
I've done it.
Yeah.
I've done it. When there's nobody to play, I put the computer on level 5 and just play.
Mm-hmm.
And I just see how many correct guesses I can make versus the computer.
And that's good practice.
And that's a hard thing to do because the computer
random
is programmed off your button presses.
Mm-hmm. So it knows what you're doing.
Right. So it's buttons.
Fucking cheating ass computer.
But I love it though. Love it.
I'm trying to read the stream monsters here. is Snake Boss and KO are talking some smack to each other.
Yo, fuck Cake Boss. Fuck Cake Boss. Cake Boss is a fucking clown.
See, I don't want to kick City Pie off. I feel bad about it.
Yeah, but yo, nah. Fuck Cake Boss. You're a fucking clown. How you gonna sit up there with your fake ass rank doing that bullshit? Talking about like, some peeps. But you ain't that motherfucking hype to see people when they join in your motherfucking game.
On PSN, right?
On PSN?
Yeah,
you ain't
hype
to see people when they join?
You know that shit wouldn't fly on Xbox. Even with this bullshit.
Snake
we still kick that ass.
That Poverty Scrub Network and get on Xbox Live. Because PSN, Disconnect, all kinds of bullshit. And, I mean, I don't know. Like,
Cake Boss. Everybody knows
even
PSN has
Snake
more players.
Listen. Yo, matter of fact, first stage boss. Damn. you fucking clown. Fucking clown, word up. You running around with a... Yo, I put it to you like this, man. If you're a fucking Star Lord, then I'm Jesus.
Getting resurrected and shit.
Yeah, I'm
right in front
Jesus,
of his ass.
Man. For real. Fucking loser. Then you have to talk all that shit with that bullshit connection. You ever seen? Yo, man.
See, I don't have PSN, so I don't have to deal with any of that nonsense. I'm gonna do it. You gonna hop up there?
Yeah. Yo, I got next. So Denkai. Got next.
You got next.
See that.
Now after him. I got a winner of your fight. You better win.
Yeah.
Better bring that.
Yeah.
Now get it. The Denkai's gonna turn it on now.
Yeah. He gonna turn it up now. First stage boss.
Hell yeah.
Damned. And for the PG-13 people, Thrasher. Thrasher.
I was gonna ring him out.
The bullshit SNES version.
See that right
yeah.
there?
I was on that Sega CD shit.
That thing came on fire.
I was on that Sega CD shit.
I lost track of what's going on.
Oh, yeah.
What we saying?
No, I'm just trashing.
Snake Boss. Cake Boss.
Yeah.
Thrasher.
Yeah. Yeah, he had theism before anybody had theism. Yeah, fuck.
There he's still talking. No one.
So you already know my vast knowledge of video games goes so far back.
Yes, he'll say that shit in your face, man. He doesn't give a fuck.
Yeah.
Snake Boss is like, yo, say that shit in my face,
yo, Snake Boss, shut the fuck up.
You ain't gonna say that in my face. Yo, you up, man? You just.
Yo, Silly Pie, can I have some?
All right.
Please, hold on. Take the mic.
SDS is gonna pop up there. And get his fight on. Silly Pie has been an amazing pie player who came here. Yo, Silly Pie, have you been on the mic yet? You should come here and talk with us. We basically just talk shit. we're basically having a conversation when we're on screen. Well, we're not even talking about the game. We're talking about like how was it fighting Denkai right now? Like what was that like?
Well, come on. What's it like fighting Denkai?
It's a Silly Pie on the mic. First time.
It was fun. All right, that's how we all feel. It's fun fighting Denkai. It's a pain in the ass at times, especially when you pick shots.
Did you get frustrated? Did you get that like feeling at any point?
No, I get that feeling when he gets drinks. when he gets like 20 drinks, then I start feeling like. Fuck. Round two. Ready, go! Lion or Leo?
You can take one mic, give her the other mic. That way you can. Oh, okay. But they can't hear. Okay. They can't hear you. You gotta yell. I think you need people to hear what you're saying. You got good stuff to say. So say that again. Sorry.
No, it's just fun because he was playing Leon, it was kickathon, and then he switched to Jackie, and it was elbow high kickathon.
Right.
So it's good. It's good time to practice defense, which I never learned. So.
Yeah. Strong players make you learn defense. Well, what were you guys talking about between matches?
Oh, so we were just talking about like when we first started playing and how we got into this game, and he got into it, I think, VF4, mm-hmm. and then for me it was VF Kids.
VF Kids, really? Yeah, man, that's way back. Yeah.
And then because I was playing on, and then the next was the arcade in VF3 TD.
Yep.
And then we were, I don't know. Since then it was VF4 Evo and then FS, but it'd be great to have all three pieces of the game to practice on.
Yeah, yeah.
So I will get the game. I will somehow figure out how to practice and get a joystick, so then I can learn and practice.
Well, luckily we have a really good Dozo mode now.
Yes.
You can record features.
And they also have that strategy guide. I downloaded it today.
The which thing?
They have an app for the iPhone.
Oh, right, right. I got that on my phone. Right,
right. With the it has a really good fundamentals and basics. I like the person who wrote it because it really catered towards newbies that
yeah.
can fully get the game or understand it. And it even has like a little tone of somebody who actually took martial arts.
Sure.
In it, so it's actually trying to help them make that transition.
And VF was always kind of, at least I always thought, because I started VF with my buddies, like I was 3 or some shit, or 4 or 5. I was young, playing my boy at his Sega Saturn VF1 remix. And like, that's where my fighting game career started, just playing my friends. And we didn't know what we were doing, but we thought martial arts, it's cool. This is like playing martial arts, but on a computer, you know?
Well, we both also commented that I guess we both started on 2D games as well.
Yeah.
And the three-dimensional aspect totally changed everything because
yes. yes.
being able to evade just adds a whole new dimension to the game.
Oh, yeah.
And each character is unique with a different fighting style. So it's not like everyone's doing a roundhouse or low, yeah. strong, or fierce or, you know, so there was more originality. And the community, I think, it was much tighter. I mean, even to this day, 10 years later, people are still very supportive so,
exactly.
and still around. So...
It's like, it's funny, in this game, like I'm not knocking any other games, I want to make that really clear when I say this, but like, you can't say Jackie-style character, really, because there is no Jackie-style character. Jackie is the Jackie-style character. I mean, you can kind of say Sarah, if you really want to say like someone's a quote-unquote clone, but over the years, that changed, and even when it first came up, they were really very different characters. They're brothers and sisters. They should have a couple of similar moves. But, like, there's no Shotos. There's no, like, charge characters. Like, there's nothing like that in the game.
No weapons.
No weapons. I mean, I kind of would like some weapons every once in a while. But...
They're real martial arts. They don't need weapons.
like some Soul Calibur style or what's it called?
Or projectiles.
Yeah. Oh, man. I imagine, like, if this game crossed over with, like, Tekken with their... Like laser beams and shit, or a street fight with the Hadouken.
How was Shun throwing his drunk bottles at you?
Yeah, he can spit. That's kind of a projectile with El Blaze and Shun. Right?
Oh, actually, if El Blaze spit fire at you, had to drink alcohol.
Yeah, that'd be really cool. Be like, ooh, fire in your face. But shame.
Well, you never know. Who knows the future of the game?
Yeah, you know, VF6, I'm sure, is going to surprise us. I fully expect it to be something we are not expecting, basically. Because, like, look at 4 compared to 5. 4 and 5 are very different games. They're similar in a lot of ways, but they're different enough. And people were, like, really mad when 5 first came out, so they're like, that's different.
I don't know. I think, like, from a newbie perspective, like, 4 was interesting for me. Simply because, like, well, I'm biased because my character got stronger,
sure.
looked prettier.
From 4 to 5?
No, from 3 to 4.
Okay.
And then from 4 to 5, I think what, at least from my perspective, which is limited, it seemed like it was a little bit easier for the masses to learn the game.
Yes.
They invested a lot in the dojo training. They have a guide. They've invested a lot in trying to build a community,
mm-hmm.
and so give it more traction and publicity so that people can get engaged.
Yep.
And even the way the guide is written, it is trying to find a way to encourage people to play and give them a basics. And
right.
I think that's something that I missed. Like when I started, I loved the game even without knowing the basics. So there were some elements aesthetically that was already appealing, but then to really appreciate the game, I think they've given us tools to do that. And so when you meet the top players, I mean, granted, they can, you know, input all of the different, you know, throw escapes all at once. But I may not have that dexterity. I mean, I remember in VF Kids, I would program, you know, Akira's Stun Palm of Doom with one push of a button.
Right.
You know, and thank God there was a training mode so you could practice. And but even then, I don't think I can execute it on gameplay, you know, but still, they've invested so that you can practice that. You can even program someone to block or counter. And I think that helps people get good at the game.
Okay, I'm gonna let him go. I want to see him fight anyway. So yeah, and you know, like I remember in VF5 first. So like I'm a kind of guy when I go to play VF5 Final Showdown, I go straight into dojo mode if I don't have anyone to fight. And even if I do have someone to fight, I'm always trying to figure out like what I need to do to get better, and that involves me going in dojo mode. And I'll use record feature. All I do is go in record feature and either test new mix-ups or test ways to break someone's defensive tech that I'm having a hard time with. And when they gave us record feature in Final Showdown, like that was the biggest thing to me. And when they gave us the ability to randomly play three different like responses, that was like a godsend. Cause not many games give you that option, right? Like, sure, record, every game should have that. I think no fighting game should ever come out without record feature. I think not to have that is just negligence on your fact, on your part, and I'm glad Sega fixed it.
Laziness.
Well, I mean, when I haven't finished reading the guide, but from what little I've read already, I mean, the whole concept is that people were afraid perhaps to, you know, touch the game or engage in it because it required so much learning or foundation, or it was complex, and it required all this dexterity. And I think they've optimized or adapted the game so that people can enjoy it. And they said, you know, if you fail and you don't win, that's okay, because it's all about improving and learning from your mistakes, and they give you that features to do so.
Right.
So it's literally virtual fighting. I mean, a lot of the fundamentals in martial arts when I took it, you know, come into play. Just even open stances and closed stances.
Right.
And they talk about that.
Whose foot's forward, whose foot's back.
Exactly.
Like, changes what street you
know,
can do.
Which way to evade. I mean, it makes sense now.
Mm-hmm.
So for people who don't have that background, they've found a way to try to bring those people to some level of understanding so that they can enjoy the game. So I think it appeals to more people, hopefully.
Which martial arts do you... I do martial arts also. Which one do you do?
So I did Taekwondo.
Yeah. Cool.
Which is more of a performance art, I think.
But it looks cool anyway.
Lots of kicks.
And how far did you go?
I got up to the red belt, which is right before the black. So
Nice. Do you ever like help your teacher teach and stuff, or like your sensei? Did you ever teach with your sensei, or did you ever help with the classes? Like you see.
I don't think so, but I think what I really enjoyed was the sparring session.
Oh, yeah.
Because I think that was a good time where you could actually apply what you learned.
Yep.
Because a lot of Taekwondo is all about forms, and being able to spar is, you know, puts you in different rooms. That wasn't your best
shot. I'm going to keep talking to Silly Pack. I'm enjoying the conversation. Then I'll hop on after we finish up my martial arts stuff. Okay, yeah, Dacko's gonna steal my turn. Wait, no, fuck that! all right.
Someone else
take
the mic.
What's that? Well, no, finish your... I can take both mics. Did you finish your story about the Taekwondo and the performance art aspect? It's pretty cool stuff, because, I mean, I don't know how many people here who are watching me play the game also play martial arts. 31? I'm gonna give the mic to Tech and Silly.
Yay.
Okay, what are we talking about?
We can start with your flight from across the country.
What?
How was your flight?
It was pretty good.
No storms along the way.
Nope. I mean, they're pretty good at airlines. No Hurricane Sandy, thank God.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh. So who's playing Jackie and who's playing, is that?
They're another Jackie, yeah. They're both Jackie. They just have like really weird looking costumes. One's got the Terry Bogard and the other's got some sort of, yeah, they got like one of
Well, I gotta give props to the costumes.
Oh man.
It looks like Battle of Good versus Evil Jackie. Alter Ego.
My God. So, well, who's the evil one? I see a silly one. Oh. Wow, caught him really bad with that backflip. Yeah.
I mean, whoever came up with carrying a wrench on your back?
I don't know. I guess the Japanese like just like to do random things. So to speak.
What's the ball that's hanging over his head?
I'm trying to figure that one out too. I thought you would might have known. Oh,
is it like a good luck charm or a good luck ball halo? And then
does anyone know?
And then the other one has a
wrist
on fire. Or golden wrist. Or electrifying wrist?
Yeah, electrified wrist, hands and whatnot. Sup, Shidosha? Wishing we here that,
Please take over the mic.
Yeah, wishing we here down the next level.
Shout out to Silly Pie. I hope y'all wasn't hitting on her, you savages. Because I know how y'all get. Nah, I'm just joking. Oh, man.
Oh. Oh, by the way, to throw fuel to the fire, let me see if I can get Snake Boss says that he probably will come to Winter Raw, maybe.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I won't hold my breath.
Oh. You really don't think he can make it here?
I wouldn't care.
Oh.
I wouldn't care. At this point, I don't even know why I'm entertaining that dude. You see my face?
Oh, man.
Cake Boss. Cool sway! The hell out of here, Cake Boss.
All right, let me update this.
No, yeah, you don't get no cake.
So
you sweet, man. You sweet like cake, nigga.
Tricky got his turn back, so I'm going to have to
sweet like
the
cake, nigga.
The loser of this one.
Uh-huh.
Which I hope it's... Actually, I got to get revenge against both of them. So
uh-huh.
Either way, I'm the winner.
There you have it. Just had my little nice little set with Ben Kyle.
That was good. That was actually really entertaining.
Yeah, it came down to who made the mistake first. That's how it's supposed to be.
And good when you have two good Jackies go against each other, that shit is fun to watch. I won't
lie.
Never boring.
That's my man right there. Shout outs to Ben Kyle.
Wait, why is Tricky doing damage to himself?
I don't know.
I think he's got a switch. Sorry. Yeah, Tricky
beating up himself.
Tricky is actually putting in work.
Yep. Oh, shit.
I think Denkai's still on Jackie mode right now. Yeah. Thing, you know? That's
right,
why I hate.
He was moving at mock speed.
Yeah.
To keep up, you know, we was going at a fast pace, so now Tricky is slowing it down.
I hate love mirrors for that reason.
Yeah.
Like, I love them because, you know, it's fun. You fight against another equal opponent, but then, like, right when you get out of it, you gotta shake out of it, man. It's hard. It's tough. It's really tough.
Right.
But, persevere. Ah, Tricky took that one pretty convincingly.
How many heels we got now? It went down? Oh, okay. As long as the people come out, man, that's all. It'd be nice to get 120 or some shit.
Oh, man, imagine. I don't even think our Evo views get that high.
Right, right.
Which is a shame.
Bitch.
Yeah, it's a Tuesday, right?
Yeah, kiddies got school.
Right.
All the VF kids got school. SDS is savoring that Snapple, that grape rate.
Oh, man, you know what? You know what? My sugar intake after that cake was so much that I said the Snapple is overkill. The Snapple is overkill. I'm going to get rid of it right now.
Yeah, kill that shit. Yeah, Cruz Link is here. He is playing on the side right now. If you want him on stream, press 1. If you want to see Cruz Link play on stream, just hit 1. Everybody's talking about Sunday GF.
Oh, okay.
Oh, stream.
Well, get him in on tuned in shit, though,
get
so
him in
matters,
versus
you know?
Gameplay.
You could basically say I'm appreciative of that, you know? Cause I mean, yo, when I years ago, even as a kid, a motherfucking stream was unheard of to me. That shit was all, it was all folklore.
All
it was all lore, you know?
All we had was you watch the person's back, watch the screen behind the person's back.
And that was it.
Or you had VHS, or you buy, shout out to DJ B13,
right.
Buy his CBS 2 and Marvel vs. Capcom 2, learn how to play videos.
Right, or somebody had the cosign that you did what you did.
Yeah, you know.
You had to have people to be like, yo, co-signing that.
Yeah. Yo, I seen that.
I seen that shit.
Or
word
just
up.
Fucking just get the guinea pig at the arcade. Trust me, if you are a Chinatown Fair or Broadway arcade player,
right.
People always saw the tech that you brought to the table.
Yeah, they always knew. I put it to you like this. When I was going to Playland 1, Playland 2. And I remember, like, around the time Mortal Kombat came out, which was, like, the summer of 93, Mortal Kombat 2.
Yeah.
I remember I used to look at people's hands as a kid to see the fatality that they was doing. So I used to look at the hands. I forgot who the dude was. It was I don't know if he was Korean. I don't know if he was Oriental.
I think I know who you're talking about. I learned how to play MK2 from like, that, like, his crew.
This dude was the only dude I seen who used to add commands to the fatality so you couldn't read his hands.
Yeah, yeah.
Then one dude had a dude that used to hold a cardboard over his hands. So you couldn't watch his hand to see the shit. That shit used to baffle me.
Yeah. I remember one of them did Shang Tsung's return to Kentaro. We got a fucking whole light kick, I think, for like 30 seconds.
Like 30 seconds
before that shit throughout the whole fucking match.
Yeah, that shit, yo, just to do that shit. Godlike. You had to be godlike for that shit.
I remember I made a
grip when I was in the seventh grade when that shit came out. I got a move list for the game, so I wrote the move list on paper. It was like five pages long. I took it into the office and I got a photocopy. When I stapled that shit together and started selling it. Cause it was hard as hell to get that move list, and my friend brought it to me. My homeboy that used to go to school in the city. He brought that shit to me and was like, he was in high school at the time. He was like, yo, I got the Mortal Kombat move list, and we had the game around that way. So I just made photocopies of it and I sold it.
Yeah, that's what's up. And it's funny too, because there were hotlines back then. Oh yeah, right. Remember those hotlines you advertised? Mortal Kombat, the Killer Instinct. Remember the Cold Cut CD that came with that?
Hell yeah. And it was crazy because you had to know the pit fatality, the babality, and then I forgot which version of Mortal Kombat it was. It had
might
a glitch.
Been, might have been Genesis.
No, the arcade.
I forgot which
version it was where they had a glitch where you could turn a motherfucker into a baby like 20 times and then finish it with a friendship. So when you do it, it keep going. Like you just keep seeing a flame and mad babies.
Yeah.
And then you end it with a friendship.
I think that was the one where fucking the broken Molina and broken Jack.
Yeah, yeah.
I can't remember, but it was one of those MK2s that had a... where the tiers were different. That's why they had to tone down Jack.
Yeah,
and
they
Molina,
had. Yeah.
I think. And they still ended up being top tier, but they had to tone something down.
Yeah. I remember
Sub-Zero. I remember that's what it was. Sub-Zero when he...
Infinite Ice,
yeah,
right.
Because he when he double froze... Reverse freeze.
Freeze him.
Yeah.
And then
when
you got too low, you can punch him and freeze the ground.
Yeah. Oh,
so it was like, don't get frozen. Yeah. It was.
Yeah, reversing 2.1.
Yeah, they had to do it. That's yo.
That was shit.
Yeah, it was, man.
Yo, I put it to you like this: Mortal Kombat was the only game that, on a one player side, the only characters you could use on a one player side was Johnny Cage, Scorpion, Sub-Zero, Jax, Shang Tsung. All the other characters, you had to use them on the one player side because they... Oh, sorry.
Sure.
Yeah, because for those characters, you could abuse the... You could abuse jump back, kick, and the computer will actually freeze while you did the jump back and kick, and then they'll jump forward for no reason. So they jump forward, do a combo on them. But if you tried it with certain characters on the second player side, that shit ain't work. The computer just keep coming towards you, and they automatically throw you whenever you fucking whip. So all you heard was,
Look at it.
Right. You had to love that shit.
Fucking Kung Lao, yo.
You had to love that kind of shit.
Yeah, man. Shout out to the Asians for teaching me how to play MK2. Cause when I seen combos for the first time, like katana style combos, I'm like, wait.
Dirty.
Man. Like, dirty. First, literally, like, you know, like, literally the first character I seen all that hot shit with. Melina, too.
Yeah.
Like, Melina and katana, I'm like, yo, what the fuck? And then fucking Jack, multiple ground pound infinite.
Yeah, that's that bullshit. That's that bullshit right there.
Godlike, though, man.
But you know what? Those were the days.
Yes, those were the no pun intended.
Right, if you didn't adapt, you died.
Yeah.
That was your money right there.
50 cent.
So all that shit about, yo, all that online. No, you didn't want to lose that last quarter you had in your pocket. 50 cent to start, 25 cent to continue, motherfucker.
I swear, man. Like, you grind much better in the arcades because you have, you know, you put yourself on the line, your money.
Yeah.
Because.
And bragging rights.
Yeah, right, too. And you, like, you figure, yeah, it's only 50 cent. Then, yeah, maybe a quarter. But you got to understand, if you keep losing, you're going to spend, like, $10 throughout the day. That's how it was for me at CF.
Right.
You used to spend, like, $10. And then, you know, as you get better, you spend less and less.
Yeah, exactly.
To the point where I'm fucking standing on the 50 cent that I was that I popped in for the
word up. My last little bit of cash,
last
man.
Last couple hours was the 50 cent that I popped in.
Right.
Then the real comp come in, then you know $1, then $2, you know. But it's always fun.
Yeah, definitely.
It's
man.
Always
I would trade that shit for the world.
I miss it, man. I miss CF so much.
It. Oh god. I miss it.
I mean, next levels are really, really, really great.
This is the shit right here.
It is. Oh,
this
no,
is
no
that
hair.
Shit
oh,
right here.
Love it. I love it. Man.
This is that shit right here. But
you
it's just
something.
That the
not
man,
the same feeling.
Right, because what really killed it was that the video games started to look better on the home cons. They started to look just like what was in the arcade, so you didn't have to go back to the arcade because it's getting, you know, arcade style graphics in the house.
Yeah.
That wasn't the case, and mind you, I come from a diverse background where I played every video game possible.
Yep.
And I'm not talking about just fighting games.
Oh, games.
I learned how to play fighting games just because they was a game also.
Yeah.
It was a video game.
Exactly.
I'm not like most people that just play, that specialize in one game. If you tell me, look, I want to play Battle Fantasia, we can play Battle Fantasia.
If you say,
yo, look, let's play motherfucking...
Battle Arena to Shindig.
Right. We can play that. If you say, let's play Super Dodgeball for Neo Geo with Kunio, I'll play that.
Neo Turf Master.
If you want to play Turf Master, I'll play that. Shit, if you want to play Columns on Genesis, we can do that. There's no shame in my game. I gets busy. Like phones without call waiting. Nah, let me stop. But, there it is.
Yeah, initially, I'll fuck with that.
Yeah, this should be
cool. Good at it, but I fuck with it.
If it ain't trash, I fuck with it.
Oh yeah, it's good.
Shit. certain shit you just can't put in front of my face, but you give me the good shit. I play shit. I even play Def Jam Fight for New York on stream.
Yo, that game is a shit.
Shit, we could play WrestleMania 2000, No Mercy or some shit on stream.
Oh, get No Mercy.
It don't get no better than that.
Yo, No Mercy the best.
Yeah, it don't get no better than that. I do it all.
I fuck with that, man. No Mercy's my
word
shit.
Word up.
Yeah, I play racing game, Mario Kart.
Oh, hell yeah. Whatever, hell yeah. I still play motherfucking Super Hang-On on emulator. Because in that game, your reflexes have to be fast.
Yeah.
And seriously, if you can control that, when you play Virtua Fighter,
you can step.
Right. Shit won't look so fast.
Just
play it all. But if I had one video game to say that's like my favorite video game of all time, that no matter what, I will sit down and play that shit like it's brand new. And this is the God's honest truth. It's Final Fight. Final Fight is the only game that if that shit was on right now, I'll walk right over there and play it and end that shit, and then use another character and end that shit, and then use another character and end that shit, and then I'll be like, all right, now I'm done.
I gotta give a shout out to also the Final Fight 3. Shit is very underrated.
Very underrated.
And Lucia is fun as fuck.
And Guy has a fireball.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nah, bro. Shout outs to Lucia, though, yo.
Oh,
another one. Alien vs. Predator.
Oh, hell yeah. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Yo, and I just became a fan of Dutch.
Yeah.
I just because he could do the uppercut and fire the gun, I never knew how cool that shit was. Because I'm a Predator warrior. I'm the warrior. Because for some reason, his stick has a long hitbox compared to the Hunter.
The best character in the game.
Right. Wait. Hold up. I'm bugging the fuck out. After Final Fight, the only other game Streets of Rage I love, don't get me wrong. I used to wake up every morning of 93 the summer, and I used to play it. I used to do the code so I could start on stage 3 just so I could wake up to that to Dreamer. But the Punisher.
Oh, well, yo, Punisher is another underrated one.
That was cool, but the Punisher, they had the arcade version. They had a Japanese arcade version in my area. I did not know if you fucking run, like you do the roll and you jump, and during the apex of your jump, you press attack, this motherfucker had a flaming dropkick. The Punisher has a flaming dropkick. Like when you reach the apex of the jump, when you kick, it's a blue flame dive kick. Oh, yeah.
The Punisher had a dive kick.
Yeah.
Hey, suck on that, Rufus.
Right. Yeah. Dive kick. Yeah. Hold that, Rufus. Now, Double Dragon started it off. Double Dragon started it all. Like the summer of 87, I used to play that shit every day and then get up to a Bobo and climb on the roof and be scared to come down.
Yo, Simpsons is another one.
I used to break a motherfucking food stamp to play Double Dragon. Real shit. Yeah, food stamps. What? Break a food stamp. I played Double Dragon with my brothers. You get the bat, they tell you to go fight a Bobo because you got the bat and they don't want to lose. But then, my friend SDS Clap-A-Lot, when he moved around my area in 88, he showed me how to do the elbow. Once he showed me the elbow in Double Dragon, I ended that shit. The elbow.
You the elbow. Tell me that it took you that long to press two buttons at the same time?
I was seven. I was seven, eight, like eight, man.
Damn.
So I had to get my shit off either way, but once I figured it out, though, it was on, Tech.
Yeah, but that elbow was the beat all end all of that move. You could just beat the hand game with that.
Yeah, but you know what's funny? When Double Dragon 2 The Revenge came out, they nerfed the elbow animation. They made it kind of fast,
yeah,
but it felt even better. because it had that nice sound effect.
Yeah.
But, yo, Revenge of Double Dragon, I love that shit. Only reason I don't like playing it on the emulator is because it has slowdown. It has a nasty slowdown.
Yeah.
But I love that game too. I like the, I might be the weird one, but I like Double Dragon Revenge Arcade better than the Nintendo version. That's just me. Because I started off in the arcade. But the Nintendo version was good too.
Yeah.
I love, let me name another game that I love. Strider. I love Strider.
You mean Strider Hitter?
Huh?
See, nobody ever, see, that's the thing. The title will come up and it will say Strider and it will have a bunch of two kanji that nobody knew how to pronounce.
It was, yeah, I didn't know how to pronounce it.
No, it was his name. Strider
Hiryu. Hiryu. Wait, I can't pronounce it, but you know I knew what it said.
Yeah.
Hiryu or whatever. Yeah. He was the man. Yeah. He was the first person that was doing suicide missions for the first stage. Yo, Hated Greatness. I tell you what I know about Rygar. Rygar was the only game that I used to jump in the air so I could switch sections and then turn around mid-air so the screen keep going left to right while I was still in air. That's the only thing I remember about Rygar. I used to, like, whenever you get up, like, whenever you pass the stage and you jump, the stage scrolls over.
Yeah.
But since he was free, if you turn around, it goes back over. Right. So I used to just keep doing this.
Yeah, because they kept the jump property from the arcade.
Right. I love it. Love it.
Move it fast, and you can like switch directions on the bar.
Now watch this. I'm gonna show you just how much of an old school gamer I am. Hated Greatness. I played Rygar so much that when I mastered Hypnodrome, the last leader had Rygar's distance.
Damn.
Hypnodrome was another game that Data East made. It was like one of the first versus games with weapons. It was Soul Calibur before. It was Soul Blade or Soul Edge before it was Soul Edge. Every stage, you bought a potion, you buy a weapon, weapon, different damage. The last leader was this big dude who looked at exactly like Rock from Soul Calibur. But he had Rygar's discus.
Yeah, the discus.
And he was tough. But I remember I won $5 because I bet this dude that I could beat him with the battle axe. Not the long axe.
Right.
The small axe that whenever you landed it, it took 3 chunks.
Right.
And if you jumped in the air and you pushed down an attack and you
stabbed it
was 6.
Ow.
Man, listen. Dude betted me that I couldn't beat the last leader with that little ass axe. I had an axe. And a pendant, I beat that motherfucker. Beat him. And I was like 10 years old, 9 years old. I beat him.
Damn. Beating on the market.
Right, Hated Greatness, you already know. A pendant, excuse me. It was a pendant that I think, if I'm not mistaken, if you lost your energy, I think it refills it or it makes your original energy bar longer. It was one of them shits. But show that shit is leaked though. If you ever get to go download it, that was the first game that had voice samples. When you fought the wizard, he used to be like, acid rain, ice storm, oh my God, I'm about to go download as soon as I go on the crib, man. Y'all fucking with me, man. They fucking with me over here, Jacko. They don't know. And you know what I was on too? I used to love Astonex. Yo, listen, I used to pack bags and then be like, yo, I'm going to the arcade and I'm not going to be done till I finish this shit. I'm telling you. Yo, I'm telling you. Yo, Black Star, the name of the game, it's called Hypnodrome. Hypnodrome. Hippodrome. Yo, and the fucking music was sick. But yo, Data East was on the roll back in the day. They was one of they was lit.
Yeah.
Remember Midnight Resistance? Yo, I wasted a lot of money on that too. I didn't like the Genesis one though. No, it's Hippodrome. It's Hippodrome.
Yeah.
But yeah, man. what's the name of that damn game? I loved every bit of it, excuse me. It was fantastic. That was the first game where you had to literally save your family.
Wait, you just got tired of winning, or what happened? How did this equate? Because all I saw was like, this does not.
Right.
This does not equate. What the hell?
Killer Instinct was good. Killer Instinct was good. I like Killer Instinct. Matter of fact, I loved it. I loved it. That was some sick shit right there. You had to be Leet to play that one. What else I was gonna say? As far as video games go, like I can tell you a list of video games that I used to play as a kid, and the difficulty level on them shits was incredible, and you was like you wanted to beat it because if you beat it. You felt some kind of gratification for it. Like, look, Rolling Thunder was a good game.
Yeah,
that was like James Bond before James Bond was James Bond. I said that it's a 2D Soul Calibur. This shit is Leet. Yeah, man. What else? Let me see. What else game I used to love playing as a child? That I used to blow like cash on it. I used to blow a lot of cash on Crime Fighters.
I never even heard of that game.
Konami. A quarter only got you 110. Right. Yeah. Right. So I used to pack bags. And we used to pack like $20 worth of quarters. And I had this one friend, Lord rest the dead. It's SDS Clap-A-Lot's brother. His name was Tet. This dude, right? He put $5 worth of quarters in Crime Fighters. So we used to pack all these bags and be like, all right, yo, we going to play Crime Fighters. We going to end this shit. He'll walk up and he'll put his money into the second player. Second player wore yellow pants. And once he got to the machine, all you heard was Konami, 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 Konami. Whenever you put a bell in, so we looking at his energy, it's going Konami, 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 Konami. So then he like, yo, hold up, I need more change. He go get more change. Konami, Konami, Konami. Before we know it, the damn energy bar said 9990. Denkai, he still fucking dies.
Yeah, I used to play X-Men a lot.
Yeah, I love X-Men. But look, now here's the crazy shit. He dies when you finish the game and the bosses come back to get you. He would die right there. Whereas you'd be like, yo, look, man, I'm not putting no more quarters in this shit. I already put $10 worth of quarters.